A very warm welcome to all of you. This is an educational video over arthroscopic partial meniscectomy and its doubts in common people. So the procedure is usually indicated in young patients with mechanical symptoms like locking, pain and restricted terminal movements. So this is a young patient who presented with similar symptoms. These are standard portals like the anterolateral and the anteromedial portal which are used. So first thing that we do is called a diagnostic arthroscopy, in which the medial compartment or the inside compartment, inner side compartment, is visualized with the help of a scope. Here we can see that there are cartilage changes which have already occurred because of a partial meniscal tear which got impinged between the two bones and the cartilage and indented both surfaces. So this is the medial meniscal posterior horn tear, as is quite visible. This tear is a partial tear and does not involve the complete surface of the posterior horn. So this has been probably a major reason for the cartilage injury on both medial and medial side of the femoral condyle and the tibial condyle. So this is the probe which is used to pull that out. So in the second part of the diagnostic arthroscopy, we see that the lateral meniscus is completely normal. Now coming to sliding to the normal ACL attachment and at its root on the lateral femoral condyle, we can see that the ACL attachment at the femur is completely intact. So coming down back to our medial compartment, we see that there is grade 2 cartilage changes because of the meniscal injury. It is also demonstrated to the patient and also a normal cartilage area to compare between these two, so that the patient can make out of what is normal and what defect is present in their case. This is usually the cause of post-operative pain and some noises that are persistent post-surgery. Now we assess with the help of a probe the extent of the meniscal tear. Diagnostic scopy also involves showing and demonstration of a normal ACL or the ligament on the anterior surface and also checking its patency. Second thing that we observe is a normal PCL. The normal PCL is attached on the medial femoral condyle and the ACL is attached on the lateral femoral condyle with its tibial root. Diagnostic scopy also involves examining the posterior horn root for any tear. Since the tear was in the medial meniscus posterior horn, the root is essential to be checked. Here it shows a normal root. Using a punch, a partial medial meniscectomy to be precise, is performed, which is later shaved off the edges which are sharp and may predispose to further meniscal tears with the help of a shaver. So this upcutting punch is used to shave off, to remove the torn portion of the posterior horn of the medial meniscus as is visible. It's very important to prevent any cartilage damages while doing these procedures, which are also known as cuffing, which may lead to further pain and restricted movements even post-operatively due to cartilage injuries. Now a shaver is introduced inside the joint and the meniscal portion that has been removed from its main body has been shaved off completely. So the shaver has a powerful negative suction device which is attached to it, and it shreds the pieces of the removed portion of the meniscus into small fragments and takes it along with the suction. This also is followed by balancing of the meniscus body, which helps in prevention of recurrence of any tear because of the loose sharp edges which might come in between these two bony fragments. Balancing forms an essential part of the surgical procedure.